Okay, to express the attitude, we first neglect the translational motion of a body. In addition, since you are now familiar with which axis stands for what, let me remove the drone for seconds. What we want to do is actually expressing the things, I mean vector quantities, measured in the body fixed frame B1, B2, and B3 into inertial reference frame A1, A2, and A3. That is because Newtonian mechanics we are going to apply is valid in a non-rotating inertial frame. In other words, we are going to express the motion of our quadrotor from the local NED frame. To make it much simpler, I've prepared a two-dimensional coordinate with a vector sitting at 2, 2. Now, rotating this coordinate frame with negative 30 degrees involves this matrix multiplication. Because your first unit vector, 1, 0, is now moved to cosine 30 degrees minus sine 30 degrees, while the second unit vector, 0, 1, is pointing sine 30 degrees, cosine 30 degrees. Also, it is easily seen that the vector 2, 2 is now moved to square root 3 plus 1, square root 3 minus 1. Be careful that the first axis is pointing upward for the compatibility with the NED or the front right down body fixed frames. Now, here's the trick. Do you remember that things are all relative? What we have done is actually rotating your body fixed frame with positive 30 degrees with respect to the inertial frame. See, what actually happened is a vector in an inertial frame of reference is now expressed in the body frame. All right. Here is one more slide for your convenience. In three-dimensional Euclidean space, we used Euler angles with 3-to-1 or GYX configurations to express orientations. In Euler parameterization, we first start with the body frame aligned with the inertial frame, and then perform three separate rotations in order. Rotating with the third axis comes first, and we call the amount of rotation as the yaw angle psi. And please keep in mind the relativity thing we mentioned earlier. This transformation is either transforming inertial frame itself or expressing vector quantities from an inertial frame into a body fixed frame. Next, we rotate by pitch angle theta about the second axis. Lastly, rotation by roll angle pi about the first axis completes the coordinate transformations. Rearranging all matrices into a single transformation matrix looks like the above, which will express any vectors in an inertial reference frame A to be measured from a body fixed frame B. However, things are measured from your body fixed frame in general. Think about sensors mounted on top of your vehicle, measuring accelerations, angular rates, aerodynamic forces, etc. These quantities are all measured in the body fixed frame. Therefore, expressing vectors in a body fixed frame into an inertial frames is more frequently happen, especially when you want to derive equations of motion which are based on the inertial frame of reference. So, the rotation matrix that you will see when you try to build the equations of motion would be this R matrix, which is nothing but a transpose of RBA matrix. Considering the fact that RBA matrix transforms your vector in an inertial frame into a body fixed frame, R matrix is the inverse of RBA matrix. But thanks to the characteristics of the rotation matrix, we can simply take the transpose rather than the inverse. As concluding remarks, I'd like to say that the Euler angles are not the only way to represent orientations. It is an intuitive way of understanding coordinate transformations, yet parameterization comes with a price, like wrapping or singularities. As I mentioned earlier, for the global representations, search for the keywords such as DCM or special orthogonal group, SO3. Thank you.